To get S-sub-E, MSE, and SSE using the TI-84, you kind of have to work a little bit in a backwards manner because the output for the TI-84 is only going to give the standard error, or S-sub-E. So I'm going to click on Stat and take a quick peek at my data. Again, it's the tattoos and teeth data I've been working with. These two columns here are the columns that I used when I found the standard error using the formula. So I'm going to ignore these two columns. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and find the regression parameters again. To do that, I'm going to press Stat, right arrow over to Tests, and scroll down to the linear regression t-test. It's actually toward the bottom, so I'm going to scroll up just to be a little bit more quick here with it. So here I have the linear regression t-test, and at this point in the semester, I know we haven't covered any hypothesis testing, so there's some of this output that you can ignore. Pressing enter, and then down arrow over to calculate after making sure that I have the correct X variable list and Y variable list. So down arrow over to calculate. And you'll see right here, this S is the same value I got when I did this example in Minitab Express. Here is S sub E, or the standard error. And this is all the output gives you. So to find the mean square error, you're going to have to take this value and square it. This is a form of a standard deviation. The mean square error is a variance. The relationship between the variance and the standard deviation is that if I'm given the standard deviation, I need to raise it to the second power to get the variance. So I'm going to go ahead and square this whole thing rather than round so that I can get the most accurate answer. And I can round at the end if I need to. Pressing the X squared key and enter. Here is MSE, and this is the same as I got in my previous example with Minitab Express. And if I want to get the sum of squared error, all I would have to do is multiply this by the sample size minus 2. The reason why you would need to do that is because the output that we got when we run the regression model in the TI-84 doesn't give all of those error components. It's just going to give the standard error, and you'll need to work backwards.